everyone. Myself Jagat Kumar Das. I'm a faculty of Civil Engineering Department of Assam Narayana University, and I'm going to demonstrate one experiment of fluid mechanics, that is effect of jet. So this test is basically for measuring the effect of jet of flow water. So here, if the test apparatus comprises of this element, this is our slum tank, this is our control flow valve. This is control valve. This is our nozzle where water can give an effect. And you can see this is our flat vents. Here you can see here also there's a hemispherical vent. This is your rod with jet disc where we can put different weights. So you can see different weights are here. So the test continues from here. So initially we have to fill the water in the slum tank. Then water is allowed to pass through this pipe and controlling this valve and regulating the speed of water within this regulating valve. The water is allowed to pass through this nozzle and it will give an impact on this vent. After this, the water is allowed to pass through this channel and it will be stored in this measuring tank. And the height is measured in this height. So this experiment can be repeated for a different vent like hemispherical vent and by putting different weight.
After the experiment, we have to prepare two tables of the data that we have determined from the test. First table is for flat vent, second table for hemispherical fan, and for each fan the experiment is repeated 3 times by using different weight. So here it is the first table, this is second table, this one is for flat vent. For different weight we can find out the rise of water level represented as R, which is R1 is the initial water level in the measuring tank, and R2 is the height of water in the measuring tank after a particular time, and here is the considered time. The same table we have to repeat for hemispherical vent. So after preparing this table we have to find out this small a, which is cross sectional area of the nozzle, by using this formula which will come in meter square. After that, we have to find out the rise of water level in measuring tank in meter by using this formula. Then the actual discharge in meter cube per second, it will come by using this formula. After that, we can find out the velocity of jet by using this formula. It will come in meter per second. After that, we can find out the rate of change of momentum for actual force by using this formula. It will come in Newton. The same formula can be used for flat vent as well as for hemispherical vent. After that, we can find out total weight. Here you can see, we can find out total weight by summing up of all the weight, that is, the first weight is WD plus R, where WD plus R is the weight of aluminum disc with rod in kg. WF is the weight of flat vent, and WA is a weight which is considered for particular experiment. Same way we have to find out total weight for hemispherical vent. After that, we can find out the theoretical force in Newton by using this formula. And finally, we can find out the error, which is coming in percentage, by using this formula. Thank you.